Good morning, children. Welcome to our English class. Today we are going to do a class with a textbook because I'm quite sick with fever and cold, so pardon my voice. For today, I think we'll continue like this and let's see. This is the second Roman number that I have showed you children previously, and I just want you to give you the answer. See this one. Okay, these four. Read the following sentences and say whether they are true or false. So, if you see here, read the first one. Mount Everest is in India. Is it true or false? Mount Everest is not located in India. It is located in Nepal. But the mountain range, the Himalayan mountain range, goes from Afghanistan, Pakistan, India, Nepal and Bhutan. Okay, children. So, Mount Everest is in India is a false statement. It is wrong. So next one. There are many roads in Himalayas. So are there many roads? If you remember the passage, there are not many roads in Himalayas because it is always covered with snow and it is rocky. So it is quite impossible for them to lay roads. That is why there are not many roads in Himalayas. That is also a false statement. Even the children of Sherpas carry heavy loads. So even we learnt in the passage, the children tie those baskets to their waist so that it will be easy for them to carry their loads. And how big are the baskets? It is told that even one person can fit in that basket. So they are used to carrying heavy loads because there is not much transportation there, no? They use either donkeys and yaks or sherpas. These people carry. Now, one can find flowers on top of the Himalayas. Now, can we find flowers on top of the Himalayas? Now, it says in spring and summer, we can find flowers, beautiful flowers at the bottom, which is the lower, at the slopes of the Himalayas, not on top of the Himalayas. So only the third statement, which is even the children of Sherpas carry heavy loads, that is the correct answer, which is the true statement, and the rest three are false statements. Now from here we can carry on from the textbook. So let's see here. Sorry, I'm moving. Okay. Now, work in groups, ask and answer the following questions. Now, what are the modes of transportation in Himalayas? The modes of transportation, we already discussed this one. So, how do they transport? By using yak or donkeys, or these Sherpas carry all by themselves. Why do Sherpas look like people of Tibet? Why? Because all their descendants, which means their forefathers, came way long back from Tibet and settled down at the slopes of Himalayas in Nepal. So that is why, although they are in Nepal, they look like Tibetan people. Okay. What interesting things would you find in the Himalayas? Now, what interesting things can you find? Snow, mountains, yaks, everything is quite interesting there. So, depends on your personal opinion. So, that is up to you to write on your, which one, I mean, after reading that passage, what did you kind of like? Now, next one, children. Listen to the following conversation. Now, this is all about conversation, no, children, in this whole passage. We were talking about conversation, in this first reading A part, we've been learning about conversation, how to write a conversation, how to read a conversation, because when there are one-to-one characters, how to read, and when there are more than two characters, how you can understand. So this is how a conversation is quite important, that will help you to write, okay? Now look here, children. Teacher Meghna. So there is no third character in this. So this is a conversation between teacher and Meghna. Let us see. Teacher, Meghna, teacher says, Meghna, have you ever been to Himalayas? So children, modulation of the voice is very, very important. Because when we are talking in Telugu, we do it differently, right? Which means, for example, I'll tell you in Telugu. మనం మాట్లాడేటప్పుడు ఎవరితోటైనా సరే మన మాట ఎప్పుడు ఒకటే బేస్ వాయిస్లో ఉండదు. వి కీప్ చేంజింగ్ ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్ బట్టి ఆ టైం ఎమోషన్ బట్టి వి కీప్ చేంజింగ్, రైట్? లైక్ ఇమీడియట్లీ ఎవరైనా చిన్నపిల్లలు పడిపోవడం చూస్తే వాట్ విల్ సే? పడిపోయాడు అని సీరియస్గా అంటారా? అయ్యో పడిపోయాడు అని గబగబా వెళ్తారా? అయ్యో పడిపోయాడు. సో యూ విల్ చేంజ్ ఇమీడియట్లీ. సో ఇన్ ద సేమ్ వే, when you're reading a conversation, whenever there is an exclamation, whenever there is a pause, whenever there is a question mark, you have to express it in the same way. You cannot use the same old bass voice or whichever voice you have to continue it. You have to change the tone of it, okay? So then only you will know how to speak. Otherwise, everything will be in one stupid line. If you see here, if I don't show any modulation or a change in the tone, how it will sound? Meghna, have you ever been to Himalayas? See, I did not pause for the exclamation. I did not ask as if I'm asking a question. I'm just reading through. No, sir, I have never been to Himalayas. Do you have any idea about the Himalayas? So, it's like no sense. It doesn't make any sense. All you have to do is exclamation. Which means it is a sudden emotion or a sudden exclamation means reading out, shouting out loud. Either it is sad, joyful, whatever emotion it is. Now let's read through. Teacher, Meghna, have you ever been to the Himalayas? That's the question. So, Meghna, no sir, I have never been to the Himalayas. Teacher, do you have any idea about the Himalayas? Meghna, yes, I do. Teacher, tell me whatever you know about it. Meghna, sir, the Himalayas are the highest mountains in the world. Teacher, oh, are they? Then tell me which is the highest peak among them. Meghna, Mount Everest, sir. Teacher, what sort of help is available to the climbers in the Himalayas? Meghna, sir, there are plenty of Sherpas. Teacher, who are these Sherpas? Meghna, sir, they are helpers in the mountains. They carry our luggage to earn their living. Teacher, good, Meghna. Meghna, thank you, sir. So this is a conversation, very short and simple conversation for you to learn. But there are certain modulations, certain places you have to pause. You know, you can't say, sir, there are plenty of Sherpas. Sir, there are plenty of Sherpas. That is how you have to express. Okay, children, next. Work in groups and share your experience of going to hills. You may talk about the following. So work in groups and share your experiences. This you have to do by yourself, children. The hill station you visited, how you traveled, when was it, where did you stay, who went with you, the places you visited, the places you liked and disliked, any memorable experience or anecdote. So all these things, if you have been to any hill station like Araku is one of the hill stations. Horsley Hills is one of the hill stations we have in AP. So, and there are quite a few. So, if you have ever been to any hill station, just answer these questions and write a short passage. Okay, children? Now, let's go for the B reading part. As I said, it is a poem. Let's see. Now this is quite interesting. I wanted to teach you in a different way, but because of my ill health I had to continue like this, so please don't mind. But at least you will know how to read the poem, so I thought this is also a good idea. Now, B reading part, if you see here. Home they brought her warrior dead. In what do you understand by this? Home they brought her warrior dead, which means they brought a dead man home. And who is he? He was a warrior and he's dead. And they brought him home. So let's see what this is about. Home they brought her warrior dead. She nor swooned nor uttered a cry. All the maidens watching said, she must weep or she will die. So as we discussed previously in the previous poem, always poems are about rhymingness. And the beauty of it is rhymingness. Now, home they brought her warrior dead. She nor swooned nor uttered a cry. Home they brought her warrior dead means, as I said, they brought her his warrior dead. Let's see how he is related to him. Now, she nor swooned nor uttered a cry. Swooned nor uttered means she did not. See, if somebody passed away in our family who are little, who are about close to us, how we will react? It depends on some people. In some cultures, they do cry out really loud. Some weep. Weeping means like sitting somewhere and, you know, like moan in a low voice. Weeping is different from crying out loud. So this woman, whoever she is, she did not cry, utter a cry. Uttering means saying out loud. So she did not cry, she did not make any sort of a sound. So all her maidens watching said, so all her maidens means the helpers she had in the house, the lady helpers who she had in the house were watching her, and they said, she must weep or she will die. She has to weep out. I mean, she has to cry it out, the sorrowness. See children, if we have some problem and we are not expressing it outside, it will be a burden on our chest. You don't feel very comfortable until it comes out. Even if we are holding a secret for somebody. See, we have secrets. Usually everybody now just promises and breaks their promises. But see, when we make a promise to somebody and we know it is wrong and we are not able to speak about it to anybody, then it will be a burden on the chest. For example, if you do a mistake, you feel sorry about it, but you can't share to anybody. And at some point, when you have the courage to open up and say it, then you will feel relaxed. The burden is out of your chest, right? A bharam tagipothundi manaki edanna konni rojulu hold chesi unchadam, edipochina balavantanga aapukodam, or see any kind of thing, evaraina tappu chesthe adi manam daachi pettadam. ఇలాంటివి ఎవరికి ఎక్స్ప్రెస్ చేయకుండా అలా ఉండిపోయామనుకోండి, ఇట్ విల్ బీ అ లాట్ ఆఫ్ బర్డెన్ ఆన్ అస్. లైక్ వీ కాంట్ ఫీల్ ఫ్రీ, అవర్ మైండ్, అవర్ హార్ట్ విల్ బీ పౌండింగ్ ఆల్ ది టైమ్. నా హియర్ లెట్స్ సీ, అండ్ ది మెయిడెన్స్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఉమెన్ ఆర్ సేయింగ్ దట్ షీ హ్యాస్ టు వీప్, తను ఏడవాలి, అంత బాధ చూసింది, ఏడవకపోతే షీ విల్ డై. నా దెన్ ది ప్రైస్డ్ హిమ్ సాఫ్ట్ అండ్ నో సాఫ్ట్ అండ్ లో, call him worthy to be loved, truest friend and noblest foe, yet she neither spoke nor moved. So they praised, then they praised him. So obviously when somebody dies, when he is alive, I don't know how many will praise a person. Although he does good things, nobody will praise him. Even if a bad person dies, they will say, oh, he was such a wonderful man. He used to be very nice. He did take care of the family. So, once the person dies only, they will bring out the good in them. Right? So, now these people, they praised him soft and low. Like, as I said, they praised him and called him worthy to be loved. So, what did they call him? They called him a worthy to be loved. Truest friend and noblest foe. So he was like the truest friend. one could ever have, and the noblest foe. Enemy. Foe means enemy. So, noblest enemy means even the enemy is quite elegant person, like such a noble person. మన శత్రు కూడా మనకి అంత నోబుల్గా ఉన్నట్టు. నా యెట్ షీ నైదర్ స్పోక్ నోర్ మూవ్డ్ సో షీ డిడ్ నాట్ ఈవెన్ స్పీక్ వెన్ ఎవ్రీబడి వాజ్ టాకింగ్ అబౌట్ హిమ్ అండ్ నార్ మూవ్డ్ షీ డిడ్ నాట్ ఈవెన్ మూవ్ స్టోల్ అ మేడెన్ ఫ్రమ్ హర్ ప్లేస్ లైట్లీ టు ద వారియర్ స్టెప్ టుక్ ద ఫేస్ క్లాత్ ఫ్రమ్ ద ఫేస్ యెట్ షీ నైదర్ మూవ్డ్ నార్ వెప్ట్ నా Stole a maiden from her place doesn't mean it is stealing. Stole a maiden from her place means a maiden has moved from there, moved slowly from there, slightly to the warrior stepped, which means she slowly moved to the warrior, stepped to the warrior, went close to the warrior, took the face cloth from the face. Now usually dead bodies are covered, no, their face is covered. So she removed the face cloth from the face of the dead warrior. Yet she neither moved nor wept. So this lady, she did not, even after seeing the face, you know, when the face is covered is different. But when you see the face, you will get all the memories, no? We used to do that, we used to be like this. So even then she did not cry out. She didn't wept. Weeping means crying again. So she neither moved nor wept. She did not even move from that place. She was still, standing still. Next stanza. Rose, a nurse of 90 years, set his child upon her knees. Like summer tempest came her tears. Sweet my child, I live for thee. Now, Rose, a nurse of 90 years. So, there are so many maidens for her, no? So, one of the nurse who was 90 years and her name is Rose, set his child upon her knee. So she brought the baby. See, this lady did not cry, did not weep, she did not break out even after seeing a dead body of her husband. She did not move even after seeing his dead face. But when this nurse has brought her child and put him on her laps, then she broke out. Like summer tempest came her tears. Now summer tempest means, tempest means like a storm. Usually on the seas and oceans, you can see these storms. They are terrible, right? Because the tides will be like up and down in so much height, and even the small boats could sink in that in the storms. Now, when this Rose, 90-year-old lady, she brought their child and put, you can see in the picture here. See, children, here. She brought the baby and put him on her lap. And then started her tears. Like until she held her baby, she was fine. When she started holding him, and she's like crying out means like all the tears are flowing up like a storm in the ocean. Sweet my child, I live for thee. Then kind of felt like, sweet my child, you're such a sweet boy. I live for thee, I have to live for you. That is what the meaning is. Now I'll read it once again, children. Home they brought her warrior dead. She nor swooned nor uttered a cry. All her maidens watching said, she must weep or she will die. Then they praised him soft and low, called him worthy to be loved. Truest friend and noblest foe, yet she neither spoke nor moved. Stole a maiden from her place, lightly to the warrior stepped. Took the face cloth from the face, yet she neither moved nor wept. Rose, a nurse of 90 years, set his child upon her knee.
Like summer tempest came her tears. Sweet my child, I live for thee. This is written by Alfred Lord Tennyson. Okay, Alfred Lord Tennyson. So this is a nice sweet poem, like about this woman who couldn't cry, who couldn't let her emotions out, because she was in sudden shock that her husband passed away. The warrior means he must be in the army. So warriors are fighters. So he died, and even when the face cloth was removed, she did not cry. When she saw his dead body, she did not cry out. She couldn't let open, burst open her emotions. She couldn't cry. And when they were praising him, such a nice man, all these things, then also she did not cry out. But when she broke out, breaking out means like crying out. Okay? Breaking out, coming out of her emotions. So when did she break out? When Rose, the 90-year-old nurse, brought her son and put her in the lap. Immediately she felt that connection, that emotion, and then she started pouring out her tears. So this is what it is about, children, the poem. Let's see the glossary. Warrior, a soldier, good at fighting. That's what I said, right? Swooned, became unconscious. I mean, see, she did not swoon nor cry, uttered a cry. So, swooned means become an, in case we hear a shocking news, then some people collapse immediately, they become unconscious, right? So, stole, move silently, okay? Foe, enemy, tempest, storm in the ocean. So here one of the maidens stole means she see, I'm going for a stroll, that is what they say. I'm going for a stroll in the park, which means walking. I want to go for a small walk in the park. This lady silently had a this maiden means the employee who works her with her for her. She went and stole means went, moved silently and removed the face cloth, right? So that is it. And now we have some questions here, children. Answer the following questions. Now that I'm showing the picture like this, you can write it down from here. You can just pause it and write it down from here, children. How do you think the warrior lost his life? Warrior means itself means that he was a soldier. So he might have been in a battle. What was unnatural with the warrior's wife? What is unnatural? Because she did not cry out loud. When our dearest person dies, what we do? We cry. We cannot hold that emotion. We don't even think what everybody is thinking. Next one. What did the maidens do to make her cry? So, because she was not crying, whatever they do, what did the maidens do? They brought their child and put her put him in her lap. Why did they want her to cry? Because if we are holding so much pain, so much emotion in our hearts, our heart will stop. So they were afraid that this lady will also die if she don't cry out loud. Okay? That is the reason. Who succeeded in making the women cry? Who succeeded? See, one of the maidens removed the cloth on the face. Some started praising him so that she would antasepa quietagonna. When she hears how great her husband is, like how everybody is praying, she would cry. But she did not even cry then. When the face cloth was removed, she did not cry. But when her baby was put in her lap, then she started crying. So, who succeeded? Rose, a 90 years old nurse, Rose, she got this idea and she put the baby in her lap. Look at the words order in title. Normally we say they brought her dead warrior home. Yes. Why do you think the poet changed the word order? It is beautiful. Discuss. For other lines with a similar order in the poem.
So usually that is the correct order, right? I mean, home they brought her warrior dead doesn't really click. What clicks is like the normal sentence, they brought her dead warrior home. That sentence is pretty much clear. They brought her dead warrior home. Chanipena tana warrior ne intiki teesukocharu. But here it is complicated, but it is nice, right? Home they brought her dead warrior, her warrior dead. Okay, so it's like the words are jumbled, but it still makes sense. Now, this is it, children. This one you have to write on your own way, because you have, I want to know how your ideas are, like why you think the poet has changed it. So this is it, the poem and glossary and the questions. So write the glossary and answer the questions, and that is it for today, children. I hope my voice is clear, but it's very uncomfortable for me. However, in our next class, we will have a normal class. So for today, this is it, and have a nice day, children.